We're joined today by one of Entertainment Weekly's 100 most creative people in entertainment. Fatima Robinson is a director, a producer, a studio owner, a style authority, a renowned choreographer, one who's created signature moves for industry titans like Michael Jackson and the Black Eyed Peas, as well as landmark events like the Academy Awards and even President Barack Obama's inauguration. I am your host, Galen Hooks. Fatima, thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Oh, I'm in heaven right now. Every time I see you, I say I miss you, so I'm so happy that we get to sit and actually talk.
Yeah,
this is amazing.
This is
thank
wonderful.
You for being here.
No problem.
Tell me about your mom and how she had an influence on you as a dancer.
Well, my mom was a majorette in college and she loved dancing. In the southern colleges, the majorettes were like considered the thing on campus, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So she loved dancing. My father was in a band and he played the lead guitar. And so kind of from a dancer mother and a musician father, they birthed a choreographer.
Cool.
Yeah.
So I've heard you say that your mom was very religious and you didn't like going to mm-hmm. church with her, and so mm-hmm. you would actually go to clubs and kind of dance yeah. there.
Well, my mother was religious in her way. If you know, religion really brought her through a lot of adversity that she was going through in life at the time. I mean, she was 25 with three girls, you know, living in a city that she didn't have family in and stuff like that. So. You know, I totally understand, you know, where she was coming from. But as a teenager, kind of growing up and, you know, just wanting to do stuff that you wanted to do, dancing was one of the things that I found really was a great outlet for me to just enjoy life. Like, it wasn't something that I felt like I was gonna make into a career. It wasn't something that I was doing to impress anybody else. It was just something that felt good to me every time I did it. And so when, you know, she would want me to come to church and get mad at me because I stayed out till like 3 a.m. on a Saturday, I would like hide around the corner and wait till she leaves to go to church and then drive home so I can get some sleep, kind of thing. And in hindsight, when I would think about those special times of like being in the club and dancing all night, it was where I felt closer to God in a way.
I want to talk about your big choreography break when you were 21. You did Remember the Time.
I did, yeah.
I mean, seriously. So you got a call from John Singleton, right? Mm-hmm. Is that how it happened?
John Singleton had saw me dancing in a club in a dance contest. And he was like, I'm gonna put you in my movie. You know, I'm gonna put you in my movie. We were like, yeah, whatever. And he had just graduated from USC Film School. And then we got the call to come be extras in Boys in the Hood. And from there, we just kept a friendship, but he called me out of the blue one day, and I guess he figured I had read like the trades and knew what was going on, and he just kind of started talking about this job. I was like, okay, mm-hmm. Then at the end, I said, and who's the artist? He says, Michael Jackson. I said, okay, and hung up the phone and started screaming and running around the house.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
So what was it like working with Michael? You had to have been intimidated. You were 21. What was that like?
Yeah, well, I grew up loving him to death. Like, I would wear just Michael Jackson everything. And my room was just Michael Jackson everything. Our birthdays are the same date. I just had this really great admiration for him. But at the same time, I knew that I had a job to do. So I kind of let all that go and, you know, walked into the room and did what, you know, naturally came to me.
And you just say, we're gonna go like this, and one, two, three.
Yeah, we kind of show him what we did, and he was really excited about hip hop. That was the cool part about it. Like, he was excited about the culture, the language. Like, you know, we spoke in so much slang. You know, he was just like, what was that you say? You know, and he had a lot of questions about like how we all started and where do we get, you know, our ideas from? And yeah, so a lot of it was just even sitting around and just talking about kind of how hip hop music affects us and how we find the moves within the dance and stuff like that. So it was really great because he was very open and was just like, ask me any question you want.
So one thing I really love about you is that you went to New York Film Academy, and I think that's so cool.
Oh, thank you.
What was that decision like?
I knew that I loved being behind the camera, and So I saw this ad for this Film Academy, which didn't take up a lot of my time because I researched a few schools that, that I would have to stop choreographing in order to go to them. So I went and took this course, and I loved it. I loved everything about it. And because I was one of the only people in my class that had been on so many sets, I would be in class like, oh, that's why we do that, and oh, that's what that means, and oh, now I see why we wait so long, you know? It's just like I learned what a light meter is, and I learned what it is. And it's so funny, my first class was about, not my first class, but one of my first shorts was about lighting, and I had gone to Hawaii for the weekend or something. I had taken a day off of class to go teach, because that one teaching job was like gonna pay for my whole expenses the whole time I was there. And like my film came out black.
Shut up.
It was so funny. It was like, oh yeah, that was that lighting class that I missed. But I learned something through that, you know? I learned so much from it. Even to me, it was like, even if I didn't become a director, what I learned from those classes really helped me understand sets and how to choreograph for the camera and things like that. So,
do you prefer one or the other, directing or choreographing?
You know, it depends. It just depends. Mm-hmm. You know, it depends on the project. It depends on just everybody involved. I don't really prefer one or the other. I like the fact that I found an in-between, which is creative directing. And so I kind of go with the flow of my life the same way I went with the flow in my career as a choreographer. So sometimes directing gigs come up and I take them, and a lot of times choreography gigs come up and I take those, so.
What do you love about being a choreographer?
I love, you know, just being able to create something from nothing. You know, you walk into a room, and I always say that the studio is my canvas and the dancers are my paint, and I'm able to go in and create whatever I want to out of nothing, you know? Sometimes I go into the room and I've never even heard the song, and so you have so many different directions you can go in as a choreographer, and how you interpret the music is basically and ultimately what makes, you know, you who you are and why they hire you.
You're a director, producer, choreographer, all of this though stemmed from your love of dance. So I want to ask you, why do you love dance?
I mean, why wouldn't you? Come on. I love dance for just the way it makes me feel and the release that I get when I do it and the joy that I find in it, you know? Mm-hmm. It's fun. Prince gave me my favorite compliment, or my best compliment. I find a lot of dancers for him, and I brought over some dancers for him to see, and he was playing the drums, and the girls were dancing, and he came up to me and he goes, you know, they're cool, but they're not you. And I was like, oh, P. Like, and he says, you dance like Miles Davis plays the horn.
Oh my God.
And I was just like, I kind of fell to the floor and was like, how could you even, like, and
wow.
He kind of wrapped it up for me like that. He saw something that I could never imagine seeing.
Fatima, I could sit here and talk to you all day. This Yay. Is so incredible.
Thank you.
Thanks for being here, Fatima. And thank you guys for watching. Make sure you click subscribe. It's the best way to stay up to date with Fatima and the world's top choreographers, as well as the rest of us here at D-Studio. Also, if you have any questions that I didn't cover with Fatima today, you can comment below, or you can post them on Facebook or Twitter, and we will get to them and get them answered for you. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.